present. I, Kritika Motwani of Class 8B.
And I, Arshia Kogana of Class 8A.
I'm happy to welcome everyone here today. We are grateful to Shivani ma'am for being here. The students will be showcasing their talents in front of you on the occasion of their class presentation. All of us are a part of Tagore International School, and when we remember this great personality for whom our school is named, we realize that he was the first modern Indian to point out that music, art and drama are an integral part of education.
Rabindranath Tagore once said, "Let your life lightly dance. On the edges of time, like dew on the tip of a leaf." The fine arts give students an opportunity to develop special skills and exhibit their non-academic abilities and supplement the curricular activities. Art, music, and dance are like partners, undertaken side by side with academics in creating a well-rounded personality. They also bring in much pleasure and happiness into our lives.
The Movie Club made movies on the theme Virasat and Heritage of India using software such as Movie Maker, Adobe Premiere and Adobe After Effects. Their movies were also showcased at Intact Film It Festival. Today we showcase movies from the repository. I request Sanya Anand of Class 8C to give a brief introduction of the same.
Monuments with standing weather since so many years keep alive the memories of absolutely with them. But now, how many are cared for? Preserving this is integral for preserving our rich cultural heritage. Chor Minar is one of such neglected monuments. Let us know more about it with a film made by Devshada, Yash and Karan of 7C.
Thank you. I am not India, with its wealth of cultural traditions, diverse climatic zones, and geographic features, comprising numerous religious faiths, and the huge population still speaking and writing hundreds of languages, has been home to a rich tradition of storytelling.
These performances, songs, lullabies are often interlinked with visual imagery. The main source of these storytelling traditions was from the Indian epics, Ramayana and Mahabharata.
In keeping with Virasat, which is our theme this year, the public speaking students of Class 8 are proud to present a tableau with some of the well-known and much-loved characters from the epic Ramayana. We also explore some of the different versions of Ramayana which have been part of our culture through the ages.
To begin the journey of discovery, here is the sage Valmiki himself, supposed to be the original creator of this epic. Here he is conversing with the sage Narad.
I wonder, Narad, if any perfect man has ever been born into the world. A man who has integrity, righteousness, skill, courage, self-control, compassion, learning, and is as brave as the Devas.
Such a man has been born into the world. His name is Ram. He is the eldest and the favorite son of Darshan, the king of Ayodhya.
That's when I started writing my epic. Rama is the main protagonist of my tale. Only a person's gata and behavior proclaim his rank in life. If my father, Darshan, has given his word that has given his word that I will go into exile for 14 years, that I will certainly honor him.
Yes, I am the unhappy Darshan, the king of Ayodhya and father of Ram. My favorite queen Titi has forced me to make Bharat the crown prince and send Ram to exile. Ram is going to the forest and I am heartbroken.
A promise is a promise. I've asked you to honor your promise, that's all. Of course I want my son Bharat to be the king. What's wrong with that? Let Rama go off for 14 years. He won't be missed by me. Look, there he goes with his favorite Lakshman and that silly Sita living after him. Dear Sita, life in the forest will be hard and dangerous. Listen to me and remain in Ayodhya. You will be safe.
I didn't marry you to remain safely in the palace. Why do you go away for 14 years? I'm going with you, wherever you may go. Even the loyal citizens of Ayodhya are still following you.
Brother, I am going with you as well. And I will help you to protect Sita. We will head towards the hermitage of Valmiki in the forest of Dandavarani.
Meanwhile, Bharat returns to Ayodhya to find his beloved brother Ram has been exiled.
Mother, what have you done? This is terrible. I will never steal the throne away from my brother like this. And if I am forced to rule, I will place Rama's saddle on the throne as a reminder to all.
This wonderful tale has been adapted many, many times by writers and poets all over India and even beyond.
I am Kambal, a 12th century Tamil poet, and in my version, I decided to make quite a few changes from Valmiki's traditional version. However, the characters are kept the same. Let me introduce you to a few of them. Here is Rao, the Rakshas king of Lanka, has kidnapped Sita and lifted in her in the beautiful Ashoka.
Well, Sita, I've given you all the time that you wanted, offered you all the wealth of my kingdom. Don't you think it's time you said yes? Come now, you can't carry your crime and insult me. After all, you've now seen my power and position, and I've been so patient with you. Well, no answer is useful. What more can you possibly be holding out for? If you marry me, I will make you my chief queen. You will give orders, even to my senior wives.
Ravan is even no doubt, but he is also the most learned man in this age. He has been granted a boon by Lord Shiva himself. He was a good ruler and made his country strong and prosperous. Besides, if a king's sister is insulted, he is almost honor bound to take revenge, and that's all he did.
Oh heavens! Am I here to be eternally? Or should I just give in, instead of waiting endlessly? Perhaps Lord Ram has already forgotten me. He has not forgotten me. He remembers you each moment
want now? My lady, I have come from your husband with a message for you. Oh no, you will not trick me that way. You Rakshasas can trick on all kinds of prizes, I know. My lady, I am no Rakshas. I can in fact take you back with me quite easily. For I am Hanuman, the son of Pavan, the god of winds.
Ravan had some fascinating relatives. Meet Kumkari, who lives feet and sea.
Now that you people have woken me up by making all this noise, you better have lots of food ready. No food! No food! Okay, I'll go back to sleep again for another 6 months.
This amazing epic has been adapted by many poets all over India. In Bengal, I, Prithibas, have adapted this story into a form of Panchali, which the people of Bengal, Bihar and Orissa just love to sing. I have created a picture of a 15th century Bengal village life in my Ramayana. People love my songs and have been singing them for centuries.
I am Tulsidas, a devout monk of the Lord. My devotion to Sri Ramchandra is portrayed in my epic, the Ramcharitmanas, which I wrote in the 16th century in the Avadhi dialect. I wanted the story of Ram to be accessible to the general masses and not just the Sanskrit speaking elite. That's why I did not write in Sanskrit. Ramcharitmanas made the story of Ram available to the common man to sing, meditate, and perform on. I am happy that my work is so popular even today, and that it is considered to be one of the greatest works of Hindi literature. However, not everyone agrees with me that Ramchandra was the perfect man. In Bengal, this woman called Chandramati has actually dared to create her own version of our epic.
Yes, I, despite being a woman, have actually dared to do something that all you men have never dared to. That is, show it like it happened. From Sita's point of view, it's not only men who have the right to create their own version of the Ramayana. We women have always suffered suppression and domination, and Sita was no different. My Sita dared to speak of Ram as the weak, uncaring husband that he was. She was abandoned by him when she was expecting his children. What else do we expect from this spineless man who could not take care of his wife when she needed him the most?
I am a princess, but my life has been an unhappy one. In the women's tradition in India, never mind where you are, which century you belong to, or what language you speak, we are all sisters in sorrow.
All these men, be it Valmiki, Krithivas, or even Tulsivas, all have a very clear gender bias. In my opinion, even Shubnakha, who most people see as a wicked creature, is actually a very interesting creature. Here she is.
Thank you, Chandra. Well, yes, I totally agree. I'm no evil ram. What is there to feel apologetic about? I saw Lakshman. I liked him. I went to him with my proposal. If he was unkind enough to cut my nose off, I think it's only fair that I should go to my brother Ravan to help me take my revenge by kidnapping Sita.
The battle between good and evil continues in every age and every generation. The Rakshasas represent our evil side. We need to conquer them.
And the difficult question of what is each person's dharma or duty is something that can be debated endlessly. This is what makes this ancient epic so popular even in modern times.
The story of Ramayana has not only spread to Nepal and Sri Lanka, but also to the countries of Southeast Asia, China, and even to Japan. The themes of love, hate, anger, loyalty, and revenge are eternal and make it relevant to each generation and across cultures. This wonderful epic remains a part of our living cultural heritage.
Thank you very much, ma'am. Your motivation and guidance will certainly inspire each of us to work with dedication at whatever artistic activities we pursue. We once again thank Shivani ma'am for giving us her time. And thank you teachers and students for being such a wonderful audience. We hope that you enjoyed the event.
We request you all to quietly move back to your classes. Thank you.